I teach three different age groups, so 7 to 12 and 12 to 16, and the third age group is everybody. With each class, we start with meditation. I believe in cultivating stillness for children. I think it's very, very important for them because it helps them with concentration and with their grades. I've had so many children telling me that their grades have improved just after meditating for a couple of times. So we practice about maybe 5 minutes or so of meditation. We sit down quietly and not saying anything, not moving, and that's a challenge for most kids. With kids who cannot sit still, we would be very encouraging to them. We don't want them to be on the spot and feeling sorry and bad. I would just shorten their sitting time. And also I would give them exercises to help be with other kids. And sometimes that helps to bring out their stillness, because everyone possesses the quality of stillness. I've worked with kids with different kinds of personalities, and they all settle down. After that, we will do some kind of Tai Chi movements to warm up. Today we were doing five animals, but next time we're going to be doing something else. Just have fun. Okay?
Crane is like, wow, so long. Look at the feather. Look at the feather.
The five animals is a very special Tai Chi exercise. They're very good movements, both for children and adults.
You kind of swing your body a little bit. The bear is so confident, thinking it is the biggest animal, you know, in the world.
They're good to do every day, and they're very easy to do, and people find it fun because you can become an animal. So for kids, that's no big deal at all. They become animals all the time.
Like drawing a circle. Yeah, just really stretch. Take your time. And fly.
Yay. So during our practice, I would tell the kids not only to remember to do the right hand movements or the upper body movement, I also want them to bring out the animal through their eyes too.
My name is Heather.
So that's actually a great acting exercise. Express their understanding of the animal through their eye movement. Monkey is really easy because we all know a monkey goes this and that. But how about a bear? How about a tiger? How about a crane, right? If you're able to fully engage in the animal, then you can fully benefit from the exercise.
Beautiful, you guys. That was wonderful.
Once they have gone through meditation, they've gone through Tai Chi movements to warm up and to become energized physically and mentally, then they're ready to act, and they can become very, very effective actors and actresses.
One person will read the script, and the other person will do completely non-verbal acting.
Every movement means something.
Okay. What's going on, Andy? I look at, why is it when you become a teenager, everything gets so confusing?
I'm supposed to wash my face before I exercise, for my buildup.
No, I'm supposed to wash my face after our exercise to prevent breakout.
I'm not supposed to eat chocolate because it causes pimples.
Wait, I'm supposed to eat chocolate before I take a test because it's great brain food.
I'm supposed to have lots of foods that are rich in iron to help with circulation. I'm not supposed to have a lot of iron because it prevents my body from absorbing calcium properly.
If I can survive being a confused teenager, I think I can pretty much survive anything. Let's get out of here. I'm hungry.
Very good. One person will start, and then when I call out freeze, this person will freeze, and the other person will jump in.
What's going on, Harmony? I mean, how can I become a teenager? Everything becomes so confusing.
Freeze.
I know, right? Are they like spiking the makeup or something? I mean,
freeze.
Think about it. Whoa, if I can survive being a confused teenager, I'm pretty sure I can survive anything.
Freeze.
Let's get out of here. I'm hungry.
Yeah. Very good. Okay, so how did you feel when you had to use movements, gestures, as well as language?
It was fun. I got a little confused because I was kind of focusing on talking more than moving.
At the end of each class, we will critique each other's work. So that's very good because it kind of helps us to bond with one another and also to help one another grow.
I like how she had a body movement and she was nice and loud for everyone to hear.
Okay, very good. Good bonding. That's a very good feedback.
You know, it's like a growing learning process together.
Any room for improvement?
Nope. And that's the program. I have been practicing mindfulness meditation for about maybe 17 years or 18 years. And I feel very blessed to be able to share my knowledge about meditation to everyone. That's the purpose of what we're doing here, is to improve the quality of our lives.